children, welcome to the geography class. The lesson that I am going to continue today is lesson number 18, waste generation and management, methods of safe disposal of waste, given on page number 302 of your geography textbook, with the following objectives: to know about the disposal of waste, collection of waste from the different sources, segregation of waste, storing waste, transfer and transportation of waste, dumping, landfills and composting. Now the topic that I am going to take today is dumping, landfills and composting, given on pages 303 and 304 of your textbook, with the following objectives: to know about landfills, factors to be considered at the time of selection of site for a landfill, problems regarding landfills, composting, meaning of compost, process of composting, advantages of composting. Children, as in the previous video, we have already discussed about the steps involved in the safe disposal of waste, that is the collection of waste, segregation of waste, storing waste, transfer and transport of waste. Now, ultimately, municipal solid waste is taken by truck to a lined landfill or to a transfer station, that is holding area, where it is collected and then transported via 18-wheeler to 18-wheeler to a landfill. Hazardous and special waste streams are disposed differently and may require processing at a specialized landfill. Now, let us have an introduction to landfillings. Landfill site is a site for the disposal of waste materials by burial and is the oldest form of waste treatment. Historically, landfills have been the most common methods of organized waste disposal and remain so in many places around the world. The dumping is done with layers of 1 to 2 meter. The layer is covered with soil of 20 centimeter thickness. Dumping or refuse is dumped in low-lying areas. As a result of bacterial actions, refuse decreases considerably in volume, that is in quantity, and it is converted gradually, that is slowly, into an organic matter called as humus. Now, before proceeding further with the process of landfills, let us discuss the few technical terms which will be covered in today's topic. Number one, landfills. Landfills are large area on the outskirts of cities where the waste is deposited on or in the ground and covered with earth. Number two, leachate. Leachate is a liquid that forms when landfill waste breaks down and water filters through that waste and picks up toxins. Now next is composting. Composting is a form of waste disposal where organic waste decompose naturally under oxygen-rich conditions. The next term is compost. Compost is the organic matter that has been decomposed in a process called composting. Aerobic composting. Aerobic composting is the decomposition of organic matter using microorganisms that require oxygen. Anaerobic composting. Anaerobic composting is decomposition that occurs using microorganisms that do not require oxygen to survive. Vermicompost. Vermicompost is the product of the decomposition process using various species of worms, usually red wiggles, white worms and other earthworms, to create a mixture of decomposing waste. Now let us go through the factors that should be considered at the time of site selection for a landfill. For site selection of a landfill, at first stage, garbage is being collected. After being collected, it is sent to the landfills in trucks and then the waste is dumped into the landfill. Now let us see the various steps which are required for selecting a site for the site for landfill. A suitable site for landfill is selected on after being surveying it deeply, depending upon the quantity and quality of solid waste, as you can see in the first picture. Then after selecting the site of the landfill, excavation is done. After excavation, a layer of compacted clay is formed in the selected site of excavated site of landfill. After that, after excavation, then a leachate collection pipes are being installed. As you can see in this picture, the black pipes are the leachate collection pipes. After installing the leachate collection pipes, drainage layer is formed. And finally, the waste is placed into the landfill. Daily, the waste placement is done in the layers, one after the other. After a few days, a final cover, as you can see in this picture, a final cover is placed on the different layers of the disposed organic matter. Then a gas well installation pipe is done. Finally, after a final tough and engineered capping is done, and then the process of LFG extraction is carried on. These are all the factors which are required for the considered at the time of site selection of landfills, and the steps taken in the landfills for the LPG extraction. Now let us go through the major problems associated with the landfills. The first very problem associated with it is leachate. Now what is this leachate, children? Leachate is a liquid that forms when landfill waste breaks down and water filters through that waste and picks up toxins, that is poisons. Rain falling on the top of the landfill is the greatest contributor of leachate. In other cases, groundwater entering the landfill can produce leachate as well. Now, next problem is, landfills give rise to air and water pollution, which severely affects the environment and can prove fatal. That is, it can cause death to the humans and animals. Many areas are reconsidering the use of landfills. The two main issues associated with landfill are biogas emissions and ground leachate. Now, Delhi government calls its three garbage dumps at Ghazipur, Okhla and Balsawa landfills. In reality, they are far from a landfill should be. These are monstrous trash mountains, including hazardous waste leaching out toxic liquids and emanating noxious fumes. Thousands of scavenging birds swarm over them as they grow larger every day. As food waste in a landfill degrades, it creates methane gas, a major contributor to global warming. Composting, the biological process that turns organic waste into natural soil fertilizer, drastically reduces methane gas pollution. Compostable plastics are capable of reducing our dependency on fossil fuels and greatly reducing the volume of your municipal waste. Now, what is this methane? As you are already aware, methane is a very powerful greenhouse gas. 1 pound of methane traps 25 times more heat in the atmosphere than a pound of carbon dioxide. Methane is also the main ingredient in natural gas, because methane can be captured from landfills. It can be burned to produce electricity, heat buildings, or power garbage trucks. Capturing methane before it gets into the atmosphere also helps reduce the effects of climate change. Methane can also be captured from farm digesters, which are big tanks that contain manure and other waste from barns that house livestock such as cows and pigs. But there are certain drawbacks of dumpings, that are the refuse is exposed to flies and rodents. Drainage from dumps contributes to the pollution of surface and groundwater. A WHO expert committee condemned dumping as a most insanitary method that creates public health hazards, a nuisance, and severe pollution of the environment. Now let us read dumping landfills from your book. So open your book once again on page number 303. Landfills are large area on the outskirts of cities where waste is deposited or on or in the ground and covered with earth. You can see the picture of landfill and the dumping of the waste in the landfill. Since landfills are covered, there is minimum air pollution. However, it is difficult to maintain large landfills in view of the increasing overcrowding of cities due to growing population. As such, the factors which should be considered at the time of site selection includes number 1. Topography. Any large area away from the city may be used for the site of a landfill. Topography refers to landform. Number 2. Land requirement and its cost. The land selected for landfill must depend upon the quantity and quality of solid waste. Number 3. Accessibility, that is the quality of being able to be reached. The site of disposal must be located either centrally or near the source of waste generated. Number 4. Cover. Cover. A sanitary landfill requires at least 15 cm cover of thick compacted soil at the end of each day's work. You can see in figure 18.2 the dumping of the landfills with the cover of a 15 cm thick compacted soil down in this figure. Now next is number 5, climate. The frequency, that is the rate at which something occurs, the frequency of rainfall, the velocity, that is speed and direction of prevailing wind, and overall temperature time relationship are factors to be considered at a particular site for landfills. However, different sites pose different problems. The landfill gives out a bad odor, that is a foul smell, and affects people living or working nearby. A major problem associated with landfills involves the contamination, that is, the state of making impure of surrounding water supplies, aquifers, that is a body of permeable rock which can transmit groundwater and soil by leachate. Now, what is this leachate? Leachate is formed when rainwater leaks into the landfill. As the water percolates, that is filtered gradually through porous surface through the landfill, the chemical processes turn in acidic. This acidic water then dissolves toxic, that is poisonous chemicals from common hazardous, that is dangerous waste products such as household cleaners, insect sprays and paints. The resulting toxic leachate leaks through the bottom and sides of the landfill and contaminates water. That is, it pollutes the water. Now here, another serious problem associated with landfill is their creation of explosive methane gas. I have already shown you in the previous slides how the methane gas created during the process of landfills. The gas is a byproduct of chemical processes that occur when bacteria decompose waste. This gas can leak into the surrounding soil, damaging plants. Now, next step involved in processing waste is compost. Now, what is compost? Composting is the process of breaking down organic matter and the elements and nutrients retained in it back to a chemical state where it is again available for plants to use. Now you can see the process of how is the process of composting carried out. The raw materials such as organic matter included carbon chemicals, energy, protein and nitrogen. Minerals including nitrogen and other nutrients along with water works to to generate the organic waste that is dumped into the landfill. And finally, with the action of water and carbon dioxide and heat, organic matter including carbon, chemical, energy, nitrogen, protein, humus, minerals, water, microorganisms are obtained. Now, composting, as I've already told you, means breaking down organic material. There are three kinds of wasting: aerobic, anaerobic, and vermicomposting. Each has its pros and cons, that is, advantages and disadvantages. Household farms, restaurants, schools, offices, and places of business produce compostable materials. This is how the composting happens. I've already told you the process of it, that brown leaves, dew, woody materials, green grass, food, scraps, manures are dumped into the landfill and they finally turned into the compost under the action of bacteria, water, carbon dioxide, and action of microorganisms. Now let us read the process of composting from your book. Given on page number 304, composting is a biodegradable, that is, waste that can be decomposed by the microorganisms like tree, leaves, vegetable peels and discarded, that is, thrown away, food items converted into useful manure. In this figure, you can see the newspaper, leaves, grass, fruit, vegetables, peels, kitchen waste, wooden materials, soil, under the action of soil, water, air, and carbon dioxide heat finally converts into organic matter, that is, humus. Garden waste like leaves, twigs, that is a thin woody shoot, grass, clippings, fruit peels and vegetable peels, etc. are dumped into a pit. The pit is covered with the soil. I've already told you how is the pit covered with soil. In the previous slides, you have seen the process, how is it being made and how is it covered with the layer of the soil. Process of composting involves decomposition, that is, decaying of organic waste organic waste matter. Their droppings also help to enrich the compost. This method is called as vermicomposting. Now, vermicomposting is the product of the decomposition process using various species of worms, usually red wigglers, white worms, and other earthworms, to create a mixture of decomposing vegetable, of food waste, bedding material, and vermicast. Vermicast is the end product of the breakdown of organic matter by earthworms. Now, I've already told you the process of composting. The process, there are two ways of making compost. Aerobic, without oxygen in air, that is anaerobic, and with the help of oxygen in aerobic. Let us discuss it in detail. Aerobic composting is decomposition of organic matter using microorganisms that require oxygen. The microbes responsible for composting are naturally occurring and live in the moisture surrounding organic matter. As aerobic digestion takes place, the byproducts are heat, water, and carbon dioxide. Next is anaerobic composting, is the decomposition that occurs using microorganisms that do not require oxygen to survive. In an anaerobic system, the majority of the chemical energy contained with the starting material is released as methane. Now let us read both the process of composting from the book. Anaerobic processes are not developed commercially, that is, on a large scale, but are receiving more attention as they do not require aeration, that is, introduction of air into a material, and are less prone, that is, affected easily, to odor production, that is, a bad smell production. This process produces biogas consisting of methane and carbon dioxide. The biogas can be used in energy production and as a soil conditioner superior to aerobic compost. Biogas contains 55% methane and 45% carbon dioxide. It may be used directly for heating or electric power generation. It may be upgraded to 90% methane for vehicular use. Aerobic composting is relatively expensive, that is costly, produces bad odors, difficult to control and requires aeration using additives, that is a substance added to improve the quality of something, and produces greenhouse gases. Three types of microorganisms are involved in the process of composting, that is bacteria, fungi and antinomasates, that is a type of bacteria. After organic material is accumulated, that is gathered at a place, these microorganisms grow and assimilate, that is taken in and understand fully, the sugars, starch and organic acids. As a result of their activity, the temperature at the center of the compost heap often rises, often reaching over 60 degrees Celsius. At this temperature, which is very high, heat-loving bacteria live in the waste. After using up sugar, starch and other materials, the temperature begins to fall. At these lower temperatures, other microorganisms like fungi become dominant, that is they have power over the others. Now the waste is said to be sustained, stabilized, but biological activity continues, affecting elements of the waste to be broken down. Next are the advantages of composting. Composting adds nutrients to the soil. Compost is humus nutrient rich soil. It introduces valuable organisms to the soil. Microorganisms such as bacteria, fungi and protozoa decompose organic material. Recycles kitchen and yard waste. Reduces landfill waste. It is good for the environment. Now let us read the advantages of composting from your book. There are many benefits that result from the process of composting. Number one, conversion of organic waste into valuable fertilizer. Composting results in the reduction of quantity of waste to be disposed by householder. Recycling of organic material and nutrients back into the soil. It is a natural waste disposal system. Compost improves the texture, that is the composition of the soil. It aids plant growth, that is it helps in the growth of the plants, as the decomposed waste is slowly converted into humus, which provides the fertility to the soil for the growth of the plants and also provides nutrients for the growth of the plant. It increases the water holding capacity of the soil. So children, at the end, I hope that through this video, you have learned the process of dumping landfills, the factors which are considered at the time of selection of the site for the landfills, then the major problems associated with landfills, then the process of composting, and the advantages of composting. Thank you and have a nice day.